All right. Our next presenter is Paulina Eberts from the College of Science and Engineering, Chemical Engineering.
My grandpa Julius was an avid reader. In the evenings, he would recline into his favorite chair and reach for the latest issue of Scientific American. But in the later years of his life, if he sat down to read, he would open up Cowboys and Cowgirls, Yippee-Yay. What took him from a science magazine to a children's book was Alzheimer's disease. Now, this didn't happen overnight. Rather, there were likely small changes occurring in his brain, unbeknownst to us all, before, back when he was still reading his magazines. And that's actually the case with most Alzheimer's patients, in that small changes in the brain begin decades before the onset of dementia. My thesis work is trying to understand what those early changes are so that we can intervene before the disease even has the chance to progress into dementia. Many of these early changes are thought to center around the blood-brain barrier. Think of the blood-brain barrier as the gate to the brain. It carefully controls what's able to enter and exit the brain, and it does this to keep your brain cells happy and healthy. But at the beginning of Alzheimer's disease, this barrier breaks down, and that can cause some real damage. With my research, I'm working to understand what causes this gate to break down so that we can intervene early. Now, we know that Alzheimer's disease doesn't have a single cause. Rather, it's an individual's non-genetic and genetic risk factors that work together to drive their disease. But whether and how those risk factors actually cause the early blood-brain barrier damage is not understood. So I'm testing this in the lab by making miniature blood-brain barrier models that I generate from the stem cells of patients with Alzheimer's disease and healthy individuals. I compare the functionality of these barriers, and I've already identified that certain genes do make weaker barriers. Now that I see these genetic differences, I'm introducing non-genetic factors like inflammatory molecules to see whether those work with the genes to even further drive that damage. Ultimately, we'd like to use this information to identify new therapies that can reduce blood-brain barrier damage at the beginning of Alzheimer's so that the next time a grandpa picks up Cowboys and Cowgirls, Yippee-Yay, it'll be to read it to his grandchildren. Thank you.